This probably should be a question that should cross the mind of the educationists, of your parents, of the authorities in schools and colleges at a very early stage. Very, very early stage. What's your name?
Arvind.
What is it that we have studied in our education so far? What is it that we have studied? You studied the languages, mathematics, science, social sciences, and then more differentiated physics, chemistry, and mathematics, and now technology, maybe a little bit of economics and commerce added to it. But tell me, Arvind, are you the English alphabet?
No, sir.
Are you the rivers and mountains that you study in geography? Are you the kings and the battles that you read of in history? Are you the molecules and polymers you read in chemistry? You aren't. You aren't any of that. You aren't Doppler's effect. You aren't a complex number. All of these are objects outside of you. Are you getting it? All of these are objects outside of you. You are not them. You are something other than the objects. You are something other than these objects. Appreciate this. If I am holding a pen, and I say, I am holding a pen, then what will be the subject and the object in this statement?
The subject is you and the object is pen.
Right. The pen is the object, right? If I say, I am studying mechanical engineering, then what is the subject and what is the object? I am still the subject and mechanical engineering is the object. But the whole obvious thing has become inverted in our minds. We have been told to call physics, chemistry, mathematics, and mechanical engineering as subjects. Then who am I? The fact of the matter is, all our education so far has been about objects. Are you getting this? They are objects. You are the most ultimate, the most important subject. The subject is always, always far more essential, far more important than any object. But unfortunately, your education has never talked about the subject. It has always kept talking about objects. An object is outside of you. Your education, your upbringing has always told you that others are important. Everything outside of you is very important. Think about what others are saying, read the books that others are writing, see what is there in the outside world. See what others' opinions are, see what others have discovered. Which is all right. To an extent, that knowledge is all right. But that is always less important than knowing the subject. And that subject is you. Never in your course of entire education have you been brought to yourself. You have been always taken outside yourself. So much so that it has become a habit with you. And today it shocks you, at least surprises you, when a course comes to you which brings you back to yourself, which says, look at yourself. All your life you have been looking at external things. Now look at yourself. Now that surprises you, which is understandable. because it's a matter of a habit cultivated over 15 years of education and 18-20 years of life. Are you getting this? Are you understanding this? You are far more important than any object of study. I never tire of telling my audiences that all the education you have had so far, all that education kept on one side and the HIDP kept on one side, and the HIDP would outweigh the rest of your education. The HIDP is far more valuable than the rest of your education for the simple reason that the HIDP is about you, not about anything external than you. And you are far more important than all the knowledge that you can gather. If you are not there, what is the utility of that knowledge? Are you getting it? The fact of the matter is, this component of education should have started, Arvind, way back, even when you were in school. It didn't. But it's still not too late. You are fortunate that at least now you are getting it. There are so many who pass through the entire system 25 years without ever looking at themselves. And it's your own life that you have to live. If you don't look at yourselves, you don't understand the functioning, the mechanics of your mind, what kind of life would you live and what kind of decisions would you take? Yes, is that clear? Yes?
Yes.
All right, good then.